out there. My name is Joann Erenhouse, and I'm the Community Relations Director at Senior Solutions. Today I'm here with our Nutrition Director, Catherine Wisniewski, and we're going to talk a little bit about a very exciting project that we're doing here in Brattleboro, which is our first fundraising dance to raise money for Meals on Wheels. So we're going to tell you a little bit about the dance, a little bit about Meals on Wheels itself, and then if we have time at the end, we'll tell you about some of the other exciting projects and programs that we're doing to help the aging Vermonters in our area. So I guess I should start by inviting all of you out there to set aside September 29th, that's a Saturday evening, from 7 to 11 at night, or any portion thereof. You can come anytime you like. We're having our dance called Dance for Meals. So we're going to do it at the Stone Church. It's a wonderful venue that many of you are familiar with. The cost is $25. All the profits go right to Meals on Wheels. We don't take anything out for administration or anything. And I'll tell you what we're going to do, which would be a dance lesson to kick off the evening. There's a very popular dance team here in the Brattleboro area, Ray and Lucinda, from Shall We Dance. They're going to give us a huge group lesson after they do a demonstration to show us how real people dance. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to try it, and then we'll be playing music to do the new dance to, plus other types of rhythms. So we'll be dancing from about 7 to about, I'd say 8:30, when we'll stop and proceed with our silent auction. So come prepared to bid on some items that you might have seen in local store windows and other things that you will never even think about. So let me right now introduce Catherine and let her tell you a little bit about Meals on Wheels and how we oversee the programs. Catherine, take it away.
Yeah. Hi. So Meals on Wheels is a nationwide program. Senior Solutions is an area agency on aging that oversees Windham and Windsor County in Vermont. For this event, we're hosting it in Brattleboro. And down here we have the Brattleboro Senior Meals, which is right on Main Street. And out of all of the meal sites that we have across Windham and Windsor, Brattleboro is one in 15 that serves or that caters to home delivered meals, Meals on Wheels. And in the past year, right now it's September 2018, we've served over 23,000 meals in the Brattleboro area, which is quite a number.
Yeah, that's impressive.
And although Senior Solutions gets funding and is able to support these programs, we could not do it without the Brattleboro Senior Center, without the volunteer drivers, without the director managing all of the details, talking to clients and scheduling their delivery days and sticking to their dietary preferences. So it's really a huge production, and I think most people who have heard about this program have a really good relationship with it, either because of their family, you know, their mother or their father needed it, or still use it, or their neighbors. So it's fairly well known, but we do want to get the word out more and encourage people to help donate, because we don't charge people. It's strictly donation, but any bit can help.
Right. Yeah. I think that's important to know. And also, one thing that we want to remember to thank group of volunteer drivers. Mm-hmm. Catherine can never thank them enough. She tries very hard. But one of the things that we always try to, you know, impress upon people is if you want to volunteer, being a volunteer Meals on Wheels driver, whether it's here in Brattleboro or in any of the other areas that we service, mm-hmm. in Windham and Windsor County, is a very valued service. Number one, of course, you're delivering meals to people who, you know, as people get older and they can't cook for themselves, or if they have some physical disabilities that make it impossible for them to cook or unsafe for them to cook. Mm-hmm. If you're home from the hospital recovering from major surgery and you just need it on a temporary basis, this is a service that keeps people at least maintained. Mm-hmm. It helps with their nutrition, it tides them over, it infills gaps in their ability to go shopping and get food. So it's such an important service. But beyond that, the fact that a Meals on Wheels volunteer driver is going to come to your door in the middle of winter when maybe you haven't seen anybody for several days, and they're going to deliver the meal to you, and then they're going to ask you, hey, how are you doing? Mm-hmm. It's a really nice human connection. And the drivers and other volunteers get very connected to the people who use the services and really do care about everybody out there who receives these meals and other services. So I want to encourage you to have people call our helpline, which is 800-642-5119, and ask to sign up for Meals on Wheels. Catherine, is there an age criteria for this?
Yes. So since we are an area agency on aging, the population that we serve are people over 60, mm-hmm. And also the young and disabled. But for Meals on Wheels specifically, you do have to be over 60 years old, and there are certain eligibility guidelines, not income-based, but need-based. This is a need-based program. I think we do have the eligibility requirements on our website, but you can always call the helpline like you mentioned and just inquire about it or ask, you know, about your next door neighbor, about your friend, about your parents, and we can help with that.
So. Great. That is helpful.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times people don't want to ask for help. So if you know a neighbor or relative, like Catherine just said, encourage them to call. Or even if they can't call, perhaps they have a relative or a friend who could call for them and make sure that we're able to reach out to them. The ones who can get out and are mobile and drive have the opportunity to go to our congregate meal sites, which are popular. Even if you don't care for the entree of the day, you certainly love getting together with other people. And people look forward to that connection and look forward to seeing friends, and they stay well beyond the mealtime, talking, chatting, catching up. It's a really wonderful opportunity to get together.
And I think often there's sort of a stigma around senior centers, the term itself, but especially in Brattleboro, it's not just food that they're serving.
Right.
There's events that go on.
Yeah.
Depending on the day of the week and the month, they have presenters, we have presentations on nutrition. And they do their own activities. So it's, I think, worth checking out. I mean, you don't know who you're going to meet if you'll meet someone new or see someone that you're familiar with. It's not just, hopefully a great meal, but it's part of the socialization.
Right. So. And they have computers that you can get on. There's all kinds of, like you said, different activities you can take part in, crafts, all kinds of things.
Yeah.
And what a wonderful staff we have here at the Brattleboro Senior Center.
Yes.
They are pretty much, you know, the best. All I can say is I was there a couple of weeks ago talking about the dance and saying, you know, we need items for our silent auction. Three of the workers in the Senior Center voluntarily said, well, I could do this, I could give you that, I could donate. I'm like, thank you very much. I mean, just wonderful. So these are giving, loving people. And trust me, if you show up even by yourself, they're going to make you feel welcome. So let's go back to the dance. That's why we're here.
Yeah.
So here's the flyer that you're going to start seeing around town. This will give you an idea of what's going to go on the 29th of September from 7 to 11 at the Stone Church. We're going to have free appetizers and desserts. The Stone Church operates their own cash bar. That's very well organized. We also are going to have, as I said, a dance lesson and free dance afterwards with the DJ. Then after the silent auction, which we're going to do about 8:30 in case some people want to get home a little bit earlier, We have that wonderful music group, Sweet Pond, who've played here at the Whetstone Brewery and are very popular around the Brattleboro area. It's a nice young group. They have around 6 members in their group. They're going to be playing for us live music between 9 and 11. So come early, stay late, or just come at 9, or just come for 7 to 9. We don't care, as long as you come and have fun. The whole thing is, you know, we're raising money for an extremely worthwhile cause. But in doing that, we also want to provide an evening of good entertainment and value for the people who are caring enough to support Meals on Wheels. So this is something you can do. Go to our website, which is www.seniorsolutionsvt.org. And on the homepage, there will be a link that you can click and order your ticket online. It'll take you right to the order form. Or you can come the night of the dance, because I will be at the front door handing out little bracelets after I check your ID so you can go to the bar. And we'll be so thrilled to see you. And just come whatever time you can make it, and we'll be happy to welcome you. And no matter what time you come, we'll save you some hors d'oeuvres and some dessert. How's that? So we encourage you to come out. And even if you don't want to dance, if you just want to be supportive of Meals on Wheels, you can just make a donation to Senior Solutions if you want. Just buy a ticket or whatever. But we will still be very grateful. And we're going to be extremely grateful to all the people who are going to be giving us the silent auction items. And anybody who wants to be a sponsor and so forth can call me at my direct line at Senior Solutions. That's 802-885-2638. And I will connect with you. I will pick things up. I will give you receipts and give you a big thank you. And we'll make sure we post your business name on our website. This is an important thing because food insecurity is growing, and especially for the older Vermonters who are on very fixed incomes, their income's not going up. And you know, the cost of food, everything goes up, and we definitely do not want to have to ask for any additional donations by the people who are benefiting. Our goal and our service plan is always to provide service for free. And we are working under the Older Americans Act and also through funding from the state of Vermont for many of the programs we operate. And we do not expect or ask for money from any of our clients. And I think that's important to know, because as we all grow older, you know, our ability to make money, put money aside, and do all these other things, it diminishes. And we want to make sure that people know they're valued for all the things they have done in the past, that we care. It's not a charity. If our over 60 adults don't take advantage of the programs that Older Americans Act provides, nobody else can take advantage of it. This is meant for you, and it's a valuable service that you need to take advantage of. Give us a call, and if you have other issues and other needs, calling the helpline, again, 800-642-5119, will get you into the portal of services. Tell people what you want. Ask questions. If you need to enroll in Medicare, if you have a question about fuel costs, if you're looking to sign up for Medicaid, whatever the issue is, if you call us, we have case managers who'll be able to walk you through all the applications and help figure out what do you need, what would make your life more secure and safe and happy and living at the place of your choice. We're dedicated to making it possible for Vermonters to grow old in the home of their choice. And just saying that, Choices for Care is a fine example. If you have been in the hospital or something, and then your doctor said you can be released, but because you cannot perform all of your daily functions, you're going to have to go in a nursing home. Guess what? If you're on Medicaid or can be eligible for Medicaid, that's not true. You can choose something called Choices for Care, which means that Medicaid will pay to have a provider, a healthcare provider, come into your home and help you with daily living functions such as bathing, eating, dressing, and such. So make sure you ask for that. If you don't ask for it, you won't get it. But the doctor or whoever's the prescribing medical person must clinically determine that you cannot do certain daily activities that will make you eligible for choices for care. So we want to keep you at home. You've been in your home for many, many years, and you love it. So we want to make sure that you stay there as long as possible. We have also we have caregiver respite grants. We have all kinds of things. So whatever your issue is, give us a call. And if you have neighbors down the road that you haven't seen for a while, they may need to have a friendly visitor or a senior companion check on them. Find out, get them to request, or get a family member to request a visitor for them. We have a growing number of volunteers. We need more. So anybody out there who, I don't care if you're over 60 and you have a very limited income, it's possible you can get a stipend and mileage reimbursement for visiting. And we can take friendly visitors of any age. They don't get a whole lot of benefits, but a whole lot of gratitude. And they get the joy of helping somebody who is homebound and not doing so well, bring them back into the community and make them want to communicate and see people. And it actually does help them live longer. And I have to throw one more thing in, and that is that as a volunteer, studies have shown that people who volunteer on a regular basis are happier and live longer lives, partly because of their ability to then stay active, but also their mental attitude is so good, and they get such a good feeling inside from making others happy. So, you know, we can't encourage you enough. Come to the dance, volunteer, help people sign up for Meals on Wheels, be a driver, join the party, help with senior solutions, help your senior centers, and also the groups in the different communities who are volunteer, and they are care groups who do so much for their neighbors and friends. They're the backbone of your neighborhood.
And we're the only area in Vermont that actually has CARES groups. The very first nutrition director at Senior Solutions actually started the CARES groups in Windsor and Windham County, and she's still in the area.
Oh, my God, that's
so great. So that's a great point to bring up, that those resources are so local, and the people who volunteer and work in the CARES groups are, their hearts are so big, and they... You know, they have their limits because they're people and they have their own schedules, but they are so willing to help if, you know, if someone in the area gives them a call and is looking for something. If we can't offer it, I know that we refer to the CARES groups because they're there and they're willing.
That's a good point. Yeah. Good point. And we can't thank them enough. So with that in mind, I guess we're going to say thank you. Oh, one more thing I forgot. If you come to the dance, or I should say when you come to the dance, make sure you dress in a creative dance outfit, because before the end of the evening, we're going to be awarding a prize for the most creative dance outfit. So, you know, just come, be comfortable, be creative, have fun. We're going to raise the roof and dance for meals on Saturday, September 29th. From 7 to 11 at the Stone Church. You want to be part of this, so come and have fun. Thank you very much.